friends, welcome back to another week of children's worship. Well, school's out and it's summertime. I don't know what your plans are this summer, but I hope if you can't make it to church that you'll bring me along with you and we can worship together. All right. Well, the first thing you're going to need is your worship bulletin. All right, let's begin. Let us prepare our hearts for worship. God, you are everywhere and you know everything. Help me to concentrate on you as we begin to worship. Help me to be still and to let go of all my problems and to let your love flow out of my heart. Help me to give you praise and to be happy in this time together. We ask this in your name, Jesus. Amen. Well, our scripture verse today comes from John 3:3. It says, in reply, Jesus declared, I tell you the truth, no one can see the kingdom of God unless he is born again. I wonder what he's talking about. Well, let's dive into our story and see. In our story today, we learn about a man named Nicodemus who came to Jesus late one night because he was hungry. What do you think he was hungry for? Well, if you said food, it's a great guess, but he wasn't looking for food. He was hungry for some spiritual growth. He needed some help here. And so he was looking for the truth about the kingdom of God. So who better to go to than Jesus, because he can answer the questions that he had. Well, Nicodemus's story reminds me of a really cute children's story. How many of you have heard the story of the very hungry caterpillar? Oh, I love it. It's from Eric Carle. It's a really cute book. So it begins one day, the story begins with a tiny egg on a leaf in the light of the moon. And on Sunday morning, the warm sun comes up and pop, out of the egg comes a very tiny and small caterpillar. He began to eat and eat and eat. And you hear throughout the week the different things he eats. And he's still hungry each day. Well, finally, he has eaten so much that he gets a stomach ache. And then the next day is Sunday again. So he went through a whole week and he hit a Sunday again. The caterpillar ate through one green leaf and his stomach felt so much better. He built a small house called a cocoon around him and he stayed there for more than 2 weeks. And then he nibbled a hole in the cocoon and pushed his way out. And guess what? He wasn't a caterpillar anymore. What was he? Yeah, he was a butterfly, a beautiful butterfly. He was reborn. It's a wonderful story. And the very hungry caterpillar reminds me of what Jesus said to Nicodemus. I think the very hungry caterpillar could help Nicodemus understand what Jesus said. Nicodemus said to Jesus, he says, "Teacher, we all know that God has sent you to teach us. No one can perform the miracles that you are doing if God were not with him." And then Jesus said something so amazing and confusing for Nicodemus. Jesus answers, he goes, "I tell you the truth, unless you are born again, you cannot see the kingdom of God." "What do you mean?" explains Nicodemus. "How can a man be born again? I know, isn't that confusing? I would be confused by that too." Well, Jesus went on to explain to Nicodemus that a person is born again with the Spirit of God that enters the heart. So it's not like we're really being born again physically. It's the Spirit comes into our heart, and not any Spirit, but the Spirit of God. So let's think about the story of the very hungry caterpillar again. When he came out of the cocoon, he was a totally new creation, a butterfly. And that is the way it was when we are born again and let Jesus come into our heart. He makes us a new creation. Isn't that pretty awesome? So when we decide to put Jesus in our heart, we become like a new person. All right? We may look exactly the same. Our nose is the same. Our ears are the same. Your hair might be, well, our hair changes throughout. But, you know, for the most part, we look the same, right? And he's just saying that your heart will be new because you are following in the steps of Jesus and God, right? Isn't that an amazing idea to think about? And I love the story of the very hungry caterpillar and how that can visually show you that, where it starts out as this little caterpillar, right? And then it blossoms into a beautiful butterfly, right? It's so cool. So just remember, when we decide to put Jesus in our heart, we become a new person, right? And let's pray. All right? Dear God, we praise you that in Jesus we are a new creation. The old is gone and the new has come. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Right? All right. All right. Let's continue with the prayers of the people. We pray for our church that it may be a safe place for everyone. Hear our prayer, Jesus. Help us to always do what is right and to always follow the way of Jesus. Hear our prayer, Jesus. We pray for everyone who works at St. Andrew's Episcopal Church and for all people who work to make your church everywhere a loving and friendly place. Hear our prayer, Jesus. We pray for the leaders of our country, state, and city, and for the leaders everywhere. Help them to make this world a better place. Hear our prayer, Jesus. Help us to do our part to make this world better. Help us to always do the right thing. Hear our prayer, Jesus. We pray for everyone who is sick at home or in the hospital. Comfort them and make them better. Hear our prayer, Jesus. We pray for anyone who has died and ask that God gives comfort to their family and friends. Hear our prayer, Jesus. Let us pray our own prayers for you to hear, Jesus. We thank you for always hearing us when we pray, Jesus. Now let's continue with the Lord's Prayer.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you, and also with you. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. You guys have a great summer. I can't wait to see you all soon. Bye.